My cat hates this knob. I don't know why, but ever since this knob came home, so I have the knob just right here on my desk, right? It serves no purpose. It's not even like heavy enough to be a paperweight. It just sits here on my desk just looking pretty, I guess.
Jeff did a good job.
Yeah, sure, I guess. My cat has her cat tower like right next to my desk, and whenever she wants, she'll like climb up the cat tower and then right onto my desk, right?
My cat does the same thing.
So the day I got your package, I had the knob just right here on the desk, and at some point she jumps onto the desk. She sees the knob and starts hissing at it. She starts hissing at it and swatting at it. I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa! What the fuck are you doing? She swats it. She grabs it. She takes it. There's bite marks in it now and claw marks. And like, hold up, that's fucking wood. Don't bite that. You're going to end up fucking breaking your teeth. And she fucking despises this thing. I literally have to hide it away from her because every time she jumps on the desk and sees it, she like stands like at attention, ready to attack.
I have two theories. Either it's my cat's smell is still on it, or it's like that thing with like cats and cucumbers when you put it on the floor where they
this
just
isn't,
don't.
But this isn't a fucking cucumber.
Yeah, I know, and, but it's like a similar like long shape tube.
But no, cats aren't like violent against cucumbers. They're scared of them.
Maybe it's my cat's smell is still on it then.
No, but here's the thing. My cat doesn't have a problem with other cats. My cat has a problem with dogs.
Maybe my dogs?
Because when I got Boo, my cat, from the adoption center, her backstory was she was raised in a household of dogs, and she became like traumatized of dogs. And I can see that evidence to this day because when she's here in my room and she hears a dog barking outside on the main street, she'll like get spooked, right? Mm-hmm. And like run and hide. So unless like the scent of your dogs is somehow on this fucking knob, then I don't know what the fuck's going on because she hates this thing.
What the fuck?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to another exciting episode of DipShip, the legitimate boating podcast. I, as always, am your host, Captain Calamity Carl. And joining me, as always, are my wonderful co-hosts, GFPPM.
Yeah, that's me.
And Jordan.
Future Trunks is Goldberg.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Okay, you guys recording?
Hey, are you guys recording?
Of course, yes. I am. I asked Jordan if we were recording before I started talking about my fucking cat knob.
That's great.
Also, this did do a clap sync.
I know. My bit was going to be coming in and just starting it with no warning, and then you two were talking about something, so I was like, oh, fuck.
That was a good bit. You should keep that in.
All right, clap sync. 3, 2, 1.
Okay.
All right. You hurt your bone spur?
No.
Hell yeah. Look at that.
See, here's the thing. I can't clap like perfectly symmetrical. You know what I'm saying? Like, they can't be like 1 and 1. They got to be like 1 and 1.2. Does that make sense?
No.
Okay. When I clap, I don't know how to make this make sense. It made sense in my head when I said it. Okay, you know, I don't know how to do this. Okay, so, okay, let's say when you're praying, right? You know how you have your hands like perfectly in line with each other?
Yeah.
I cannot clap like that. If I clap like that, my two ring fingers slap together. And that aggravates the bone spur.
Why would
but if
you
I
clap like that, you gotta clap at an angle.
That's what I'm doing now to avoid hitting the bone spur.
Wait a minute, P- PM, do you pray with your hands like symmetrical flat against each other?
I don't pray at all, man. Like, I don't answer my prayers.
When you're talking about prayer, are you talking about like both hands flat up against each other or like both hands interlocked?
That's what the fucking emoji is, dude. It's the fucking praying hands.
Two hands.
Okay, sure.
You can do it either way. You can either do it with your hands together like that or with your hands like your fingers intertwined.
You can clasp them together like ball your fists or fucking, you know, emoji style. You're a Zoomer. You should know this.
I was gonna say, I only know the putting your hands together, like,
I very rarely use emojis.
I very rarely fuck your mother.
Oh, thank you for doing it rarely.
Does she still ask for me? Does she still think about me?
Does she cry herself to sleep thinking about the time we had?
So what I meant by future Trunks being Goldberg.
Yeah, let's avoid this topic.
So I was thinking about how like a lot of plot points in Dragon Ball would not fly in like the modern like manga space.
Mm-hmm.
Like, could you imagine in like the modern day of like weekly chapter releases, like a major character's son from the future comes out of nowhere and kills the previous arc villain?
I mean, does an RKO on him?
Didn't, like, Boruto kind of do that?
Boruto went back in time, I think, just to interact and do nothing else.
Oh, okay. What?
Yeah,
I haven't caught up with Boruto. I don't know what the fuck's going on in that. I don't know.
I know Boruto and Sasuke went back in time to when, like, Naruto was a child and, like, had adventures with them. But that's my extent of knowledge.
And basically the gist of my comparison is they sell future Trunks like a wrestler by having him just eliminate the superstar instantly, basically.
It becomes a squash match.
Yeah. And then he becomes a jobber for the rest of the series.
And that's... Yeah.
He does a cool thing every now and then, and then they're just like, no, actually, he's being a little too cool. We gotta throw him into the dirt, remind him where he came from.
Oh, so Gohan. Because that's what they did with Gohan.
Yep.
After Cell Saga, job him. Who fucking cares? Fuck Gohan.
Gohan is one of the strongest Saiyans who ever lived. JK, it's still Goku. Gohan's nothing.
It's still Goku. You think he would have, like, passed on a little something? Like, everything Goku can do, Gohan should be able to do it better. Because he's the younger one. He's the younger, newer one. Teach him Kaioken. Get him God Super Saiyan status. He should have it. He's got the fucking blood for it. Don't tell me otherwise.
Gohan hasn't even went to Super Saiyan 3, has he?
Fuck, I don't know.
Canonically, like, only Goku and Gotenks go Super Saiyan 3. Not even Vegeta goes Super Saiyan 3.
That's so dumb. I mean, Vegeta doesn't need to now, I guess. He skipped over that to the better shit, but...
He skipped over it, like, in both canons. He went straight to 4 and GT and God and Super. Anyway, how was everybody's weeks?
I fell and busted my ass at work.
Again?
Oh.
So soon?
I didn't fall the first time. The first time, I don't know what the fuck happened with my back. It just decided it wanted to hurt.
Did you miss the vacation, paid-at-home lifestyle and try to re-injure yourself? Trying to stay back home again?
It wasn't intentional, but God, that would have been nice. I was dumping garbage. I was like going out to the dumpsters to throw my garbage out. And when I was like walking back from doing that, my ankle just caved in and I just like flopped around and fell right down on my ass. Landed on the radio that I had on my pants pocket in the back. Hurt a lot. Got a big bruise on my butt, right on the right cheek. Hurt my arm a little bit, so I can't really lift it too much with it. Actually, it feels a lot better now, but like it fucking hurt to like lift it up, but I feel a lot better now.
That's good, at least.
I also slit my thumb on a can.
Jeez. Oh.
I had a rough first 3 days back at work. I was like, oh, I slit my thumb, oh, I fucked up my arm, oh, I fell on my ass. What's going on?
Did it leave a scar? Do you guys have scars?
I have a little. Like it's still healing, so it's like bumpy and scarred over, and it's.
Do you have any scars, Jordan?
I didn't really get into any many injuries in my life, so I don't have any scars.
I have scars on my left arm.
I have scars on my back, clearly, from all the under the knifing. I have a scar on, which shoulder is it? It's my left shoulder of a bullet wound. I had for like a decade plus, a scar on my dick, on the base of my dick.
She bit it.
No, not her. Someone else.
Was it a dog?
Something else. Yes, it was the dog. It was
I remember you saying that story before.
Yeah, Jordan doesn't know the story. Okay. So when I was an adolescent, me and my mom went to this pet store to talk to the owner, because my mom had business with her or whatever. And it was also a place where you can get like your pets groomed, right? So in the back were like 5-6 dogs, and while my mom was doing her business with the owner, I was back there hanging out with the dogs, and they were very friendly. And there was this one little fucking prick, this little shih tzu, and he was jumping up and I was petting him, and he got a little too excited, and he bit at my crotch area and latched on my dick. So I immediately start screaming for help, asking for my mother to help me. And all I get from from her is her telling me to shut up. I'm embarrassing her. So I'm muffled screaming, trying to get this dog off my dick until I finally push away the dog and I'm free from its fucking grasp. And then later on that night, I go home and I check, and on the base of my dick, there is just a scar in the shape of a C, and it was on there for like a good 10 plus years. And then not too long after that incident, I told my mom about it, and she talked to the owner, thinking that she was probably going to get some money out of it. Oh, one of your dogs injured my son. And it turned out the name of that dog was Coco. So that fucking dog, that dog branded me with its mark. It left a mark of C on me for a decade plus.
I forgot that was the dog that you keep calling Hotel.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's right. I forgot I started calling Alto Coco.
Yeah. That's so good.
Yeah, that's why KZ didn't let me tell that bit on stream one time. When I told it so many times before.
Yo, Alto smoking penis?
Alto smoking dick?
He was certainly biting it, that's for sure.
It 100%. Hurt. I'm sure it did.
Left a mark.
What about your week, PM?
Okay, I guess I can segue straight into cheat meal.
Love to hear it.
Love to hear cheat meal of the week.
So I'm going to let everybody know that this is the end of season one of Cheat Meal, because legitimately, I'm going back to just like straight up hardcore dieting. Because seriously, ever since I started cheating on my diet, things have gotten so much worse. It's literally once a week, every week, something with the cheat meal goes wrong. It is literally fueling my depression. I can't deal with this. I am spiraling down into a not very happy place.
Oh my god.
Because of what happened yesterday.
Oh no.
Yesterday, it was actually this morning, like early this morning. So I pretty much slept through the entire day. I woke up at like 1:30 in the morning. That's why I wasn't at your stream, Carl.
Bastard.
At like 2:15 in the morning, I'm like, oh fuck, I'm hungry. Might as well go get my cheat meal. So I go to my local McDonald's, thinking that because I still have one of those value thing, one of those coupons of the free meals.
Yeah, the
I got
meal
before
ones.
Yeah, thinking that I can go turn it in, but when you're ordering through the app and not allowed to go inside, you can't actually use your coupon. You need to actually fucking pay for it. I'm like, well, fine, fuck it. I'm like, all right, fuck it, let's get some nuggies. So I'm happy that the world is slowly returning to normal, but at the same time, I'm not. Because during the height of COVID, whenever I would go out on a Saturday night, The streets were barren. They were fucking empty. And now it's to the point where everything's opening up. So everything's like pretty much back to normal, where there are just shit tons of people at like 2-3 o'clock in the morning, drunk and high off their asses, like no to fucking morrow. Like, legitimately, it's like a fucking 7-minute walk to my local McDonald's. I counted like 8 different piles to throw up on my way to the McDonald's. There was so, there's just, and it's just, oh, the combination of smells, it's just so bad. So I get to the McDonald's. I place my order on the app, and I'm waiting for my food. Thankfully, there weren't like 30 Ubers this time waiting to pick up orders. It wasn't 4 o'clock in the morning, so that's probably why. So I'm waiting for my food. And I see across the street, like, a group of, like, 6-7 kids, like, around the 20-ish.
My age.
Yeah, around Jordan's age.
Yeah, kids. They, like 12-year-olds.
Yeah, exactly. They're all kids to me anyway. So they're crossing the street coming towards the McDonald's. And
the McDonald's.
So the dude comes out to bring out someone else's food, not mine. And he hands the guy the food, and one of these drunk kids walks up to the McDonald's guy and goes, oh, are you closed? And the guy's like, no, you gotta, we're open. You gotta order through the app or go through the drive-thru. And this dude, the drunk dude, he is so shit-faced. He is like, one misstep and he's on the ground and he's staying on the ground. Like, he doesn't need to fall from a tree. All he needs is one slight tumble, and he's out for the night. He's swaying back and forth, and he looks pale. Like, he looks like he's going to throw up any minute now, and to the point where, like, I'm a couple feet away from him thinking that he's going to throw up any second now. So the dude goes back inside, and the group of kids is still out here just thinking about what they're going to do. No one wants to download the app. No one has fucking data. No one has the app. No one wants to download the app. So they're trying to figure out what they're going to do with food. Until the dude finally comes out from the McDonald's again. And this time he has my food. But instead of just straight handing me the food after I showed him my code, the drunk dude comes back up again. And he goes, we can't like walk through the drive-thru, right? You won't take our order then, because we don't have the app. No one wants to download the app. We really want to order food, so either can we walk through the drive-thru, or you can take our order here. And it's like, and he's like, I'm not at all the while with my food in his hand, just not giving me my food, even though I showed him the code and he knows that it's my food. He's just fixated on answering this drunk kid's question. I'm like, just give me the food, just give me the food. Refuses to give me the food. Answering this dude's question, and he's like, no, you can't walk through the drive-thru. And I'm not taking your order, order through the app. And the drunk dude, he's about to say something else, right? He says like two words, doesn't get through the two words because projectile vomit just starts coming out of his mouth. Mm-hmm. Right onto the McDonald's guy, right onto my food that he's holding still. So now... I'm livid. I'm livid. I'm about to fucking to punch this kid in the mouth. I'm about to punch the McDonald's guy in the mouth because he didn't give me my fucking food. I just wanted my food. I showed him the code. I showed him my phone. He should have just given me the fucking food. But he didn't, and now there's throw up on it. So he goes, oh, this was yours, right? Still drenched in vomit. I'm like, yeah, that was mine. You know it was mine. So he goes, oh, sorry, I'll go take care of this after I take care of myself. Like, yeah, sure, go ahead, do your thing. So I waited for like another 30 minutes because they fucking cooked them up fresh for me. And then they threw in like two more fucking free meal vouchers. I'm like, I don't... you could have just given me the food.
When did these vouchers expire?
The first ones that I got expire at the end of this month. The other ones I didn't look at yet.
You at least got your new food, though.
Yes, I did get my new food.
Okay.
Were you able to eat this food?
Yes, I was able to eat this food. After trials and tribulation. Oh, by the way, the drunk kid who vomited, he realized that he fucked up and threw up all over the dude and my food. So he turns towards me and he starts talking to me. And I'm like, oh, you're not done. Because, Jordan, I used to work at a bar for 10 years. So I know when motherfuckers are about to throw up, right? Yeah. And I'm like, oh, you just got done wave one. You still got round two left in you. I could see it in his face. It's ready to come out. So he turns towards me, walk towards me to talk to me. And I'm like, no, you're good. And I'm literally walking back away from this motherfucker. He starts to say something to me. I couldn't make out what it was. But round two, wave two did in fact come out. But thankfully, I had the wherewithal to fucking back away. So he just threw up on the floor.
Oh, man.
Like, man.
So, I'm going hardcore on my diet again. I'm going to let these fucking McDonald's coupons expire, or I'm going to give them to somebody because I'm done. Every time I try to break my diet, something goes wrong. So I'm done.
This is why you should just have like food delivery apps. Just go through those.
Yeah, but that's
pray
more,
that it doesn't break.
That's more expensive. And
that's true. Know,
look, here's the thing. Remember last week when I told you about Domino's? That was through food delivery.
Yeah, you're right. That was.
And well, look at what happened there. Fucking Ron that? Jeremy trips over a fucking dog and I have no pizza.
Was that through a delivery app?
No,
like, separate
that
from
was,
them?
That was through Domino's.
There you go. I mean, you might end up the person who gets a message from their like DoorDasher or whatever, and they're just like, haha, I eat your food.
Haha, I take bite.
Send you a picture of it.
I've only ordered through like Uber twice. Once from Burger King, another time for a poutine. Both times were absolutely fine. Showed up on time. Very courteous delivery people. Absolutely no problems whatsoever. But then again, I wasn't at a diet on a diet at that point, so I wasn't shifting karma in any sort of way. Doing it now, I'm sure like every single meal will have like half of it eaten by the time it shows up at my door. So
wasn't
no,
it the, wasn't it the president of Russia, Putin?
Putin.
Putting these nuts in your mouth, stupid.
I knew it. I went with it anyway. Oh, so recently, episode 6 of the podcast came out. Legitimately, probably our best episode to date. Mm-hmm. I said something in that podcast, and thankfully, nobody picked it up. Nobody in the comments, neither of you two picked it up. So I'm just going to fucking oust myself right now.
Okay.
During that episode's cheat meal, when I was talking about the salsa packets and talking about how they're made out of titanium and impossible to open, instead of saying easy to open, I said open to easy. and nobody called me out on it. Nobody called me out on it. It reminds me of that time during one of the Nuzlocks that me and KZ were doing. I got hit with close combat by a fucking Arcanine, right?
Mm-hmm.
And in my rage, I wanted to say something to the effect of paws into fists or fists into paws, but instead I said faws into pists. It just happens sometimes when I get like too excited or too high. It happens a lot. where I'll just take my sentence and just rearrange it. I'll just like fun libs, fun libs. What is it called? Mad libs. Adam. I'll just ad libs, mad libs, my own fucking sentences.
Yeah.
So yeah, that happened on episode 6. Nobody called it out. So I'm calling myself out because I noticed it when I was listening to our podcast.
Speaking of episode 6,
mm-hmm.
we have a lead. That this like scooter guy is apparently like a vandal in Toronto.
Apparently, this is the first that I definitely saw the guy. But I'm glad that somebody out there knows. Honestly, it's kind of sad that this is a known thing. I really wish it wasn't. This is akin to the serial shitter that appeared in Toronto a couple of years ago. Back when I was working at the gym, just this regular college dude, just filling up a bucket full of like human feces and throwing it at people and places.
And this wasn't
like promoting a YouTube channel or anything. This dude was just, I don't know, mad at the world and just started filling buckets of presumably his own shit. I don't know where he's getting the shit from, but he's filling buckets of feces and throwing it at people, throwing it at fucking buildings. And here's the scariest thing, Jordan. Every single, like, I think he hit like three or four. He appeared like three or four times in a spree, right? In a shitting spree. Mm-hmm. Every single target that he hit was getting closer and closer to my gym. So every single day, I was afraid to get to the gym to find just doo-doo just smeared all over the walls like fucking Eddie Murphy in Daddy Daycare. Just seeing it up in the ceilings. No, that was a scary time.
It got me doo-doo.
Carl, what's this piss bucket?
What do you mean?
What's this piss bucket?
Do you have a piss bucket in your room?
No, you just added a piss bucket.
What are you talking about?
Was this always here? What is...
Oh, MPM's piss bucket. Yeah, that's what we pay him with. We provide him with a bucket to pee on the boat.
Oh, okay.
Because he's not allowed to use the bathroom.
You should have worded that faster, because I presume that we paid him in piss.
We fill up a bucket of piss and he gets to drink it. That's his reward.
No.
They call it liquid gold.
I'm talking about my week now.
We are in our Kelly. Okay, Jordan, tell me about your week.
So I discovered that my dog has a rival.
What? Is it the shed?
So
does he also have a knob that he's scared of?
So PM. I now understand the vitriolic hatred of raccoons.
Thank you. Finally. This podcast hates two things, deers and raccoons.
Okay. It's either a raccoon or a possum. Because like 6 years ago, my dog brought a possum up to the back door that was dead in his mouth.
Okay.
But there is something living inside my shed.
Jordan.
What?
Jordan, do you think that... The possums remember that act and are trying to exact revenge on your dog? Is that what you're trying to say?
No, the way I know this is a rival. I have learned that my dog does this every year. I told my dad that he was doing this and he was like, oh yeah, he does that every winter. So I'm convinced that every winter, some creature is going to live in my fucking shed. And my dog Merlin is trying to kill it. And Merlin is tearing apart this fucking shed to get to this fucking creature.
I saw the videos. It's fucking wild.
The possum turns to your dog and is like, hello, my name is Inigo Montoya. You killed my father. Prepare to die.
So, Carl, put this video in the video version.
No. Like, okay. No. No. Okay, here it is.
Oh!
Why is he doing that?
He's trying to open up a big enough hole so that he can get into the shed, I think?
He's trying to get in and murder. I think your dog's just a cold-blooded killer.
I mean, he's got bloodhound in him, so it's possible.
Either that, or, like, you're gonna go outside one day, and you're just gonna, like, see a raccoon's face pop out from the shed, and it's gonna go, Kiryu-chan! And it's gonna try and murder you or your dog, or both.
Oh, the raccoon everywhere system?
Yeah, the raccoon everywhere.
I've been dealing with that shit for the past like 6 years. It's finally your dog's turn. Get the curse off of me.
I keep waiting for the day where I like come home from work. We have to put out like our garbage pails in the street to like save spots on the street for us to park in. I keep waiting for the day where I pass by our really big bush and a raccoon just pops out and attacks me. Hasn't happened yet.
I nearly shit my pants the other day attempting to throw out the garbage. I went to go fucking throw out recycling. I open up our recycling bin, and there's just like three squirrels in our recycling bin. And they all fucking spaz out and jump out like it's a fucking clown car. I drop my garbage, fall flat on my ass, and I farted on impact. And I sharded a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. I did in fact shard a little bit. I sharded on impact. I also accidentally threw one of my garbage bags like over my head into the neighbor's yard, and I couldn't get back into it because their gate is locked, so I couldn't like go there and pick up my garbage. Like, well, that's your problem now.
Now you're a vandal.
It was accidental vandalism.
What other crimes did you do this week, PM?
Nothing to my knowledge.
Because by the time this episode releases, they'll know about the accidental cookie.
Like I said, it was an accident.
Well, yeah, it was an accident. You also talked about how you pirated a game.
Hey. Didn't pay for it yet because I had to pay rent this week. So as soon as I get my next check, I'm definitely going to support the developers for sure.
Good for you.
God, it's alive.
It's a good game. You should buy it. Don't pirate it like I did.
So here's something about the episode 7 that I noticed while editing. Someone asked us the story about the beans room, and we did tell the story, but an audio issue happened where it just sort of cut out.
That
and
was
distorted.
That was in the last episode, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened there.
Yeah, it was something with my audio. I get a little excited sometimes, and I hold my mic because I don't have like a microphone stand like you two do, like a mic arm. I have my thing on like a, what is this? It's a little mic stand, but I can pick it up and hold it. So like when I'm talking into it, I hold it like a stand-up comic. So sometimes I'll get like a little too animated and excited, and the fucking wire in the back will sometimes like jiggle out. So
it was more than just yours. It was all three of us. It just
I clearly remember freaking out about like the dude that was jerking off in there, but like my audio just completely bugged out there.
Hold on, I gotta let my fucking cat out.
What the cat doing?
What the cat doing?
The cat doing?
The cat doing?
Being a bitch, I guess.
Oh, that's a female dog.
Fuck, I mean, you're right. You got me there.
What you didn't hear at the start of the podcast, Carl, is apparently PM's cat hates the bat knob.
I caught a bit of it.
She despises it. She hisses at it. She fucking tried biting it. There's bite marks all over this fucking thing.
Speaking of that knob, I'm never mailing anything to Canada ever again.
Yeah, don't, because I end up paying for it. Like, I basically just got, like, a used discounted copy of fucking Mario Party and a knob. That's it.
I felt so bad, because I had no idea that was going to happen.
That's fucking funny. You know this what? It was well-deserved.
So, how did I deserve this?
You're a fucking criminal.
The surprise I had... So, for the audience, the surprise I had with PM's knob was a copy of Mario Party, and I went to UPS to mail it to Canada. It cost me about $25 shipping, just because I also had to pay for a box to put them in, but, you know, that's fine. When PM gets it, he has to pay $36 to get his package.
Yeah, it costs more to receive it than it was to actually ship it. That's... it's fucked up.
I don't get it.
I don't get it either. I don't care. I played Mario Party. And guess what? I hate it. I fucking hate Mario Party so much.
Who'd you play it with?
Nobody. I played it by myself with master computers.
Hey, you want to play Mario Party after this?
Yeah, sure. Oh. Fine. Fuck it. I'll be on 30 hours of no sleep by the end of this podcast.
Yeah, he's been up for like 30 hours apparently.
Why would you do that?
That's a good question. Anyway, this coffee's delicious.
It sounds like it is.
Mm-mm.
Keeping you alive? Saturated?
Yep.
Weren't late. Wasn't late this time because of coffee.
Liquidated?
Yeah, I got coffee on time today.
PM was early.
PM was really early. Jordan, you were in here like at 5:40 something. I was like, what the fuck are you doing in there?
I had nothing better to do. I had my dinner. I had a shower.
My life is sad. All I have is this.
Yeah, basically.
I mean, same. Yeah, I feel that. Hello, everybody. This is your captain speaking. Thank you for listening to episode 8 of DipShips. I hope you're all enjoying it so far. Just doing a couple little housekeeping things here. Just, you know, a little general stuff. Don't forget to follow us all on Twitter at DipShipsPod. And don't forget that you can follow us all individually at TheCalamityCarl, at ExPayline, and at GFPPM. If you want, if you're not aware, we're available on a lot of different spots other than where you're listening. We're available on Podbean, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Amazon Music, and of course our video version on YouTube. So check them out wherever you want, wherever you listen to them, other than this, whatever you are on. I don't know. Thank you to Vitizen on Twitter for our wonderful intro song, Starboard. Our theme song, pretty much. It's a very good song. Love it a bunch. Go and support ya boy. And thank you to Shibuya Gato and Shura Art for our channel art, such as our logo, our art that you're seeing for the thumbnails, and other such things like that. If you have any questions or any topics for us to cover, then make sure you send them to dipshipspod@yahoo.com or reply to the tweet that is put out every Sunday by our unpaid intern. One day he's moving up. He already got his little bucket. Go pee-pee in it. A little splash. I like to sit in the splash zone. Live a little dangerously. Never know. It gets on me, and then I run up to Jordan, and I rub it on him, and he screams. It's funny. Stupid. Hey, the stuff's still in the works? Yeah, still in the works. It's still being ironed out and worked on. Y'all can have probably already guessed what it is, and you probably already know what it is. But it'll be probably out around episode 10. You'll be excited to see the tiers we have for it. Get pumped. Some of you might enjoy seeing a certain someone watch a certain some things like you used to, you know? Anyway, that's enough teasing. It's enough of a little tease. I hope you all enjoy the rest of the episode.
Hello. If you're listening to this podcast, then you're either a big fan of boats or a big fan of listening to friends goof off for a few hours. Well then, I have excellent news for you. Yu-Gi-Oh! The Show has plenty of boats. And The Millennium Microphone is a podcast where four friends rewatch the show with boats and also goof off for a few hours every other week. It features that Carl guy that you've been listening to here, along with Shora, BioRoxus, and me, Shibuya Gato. Check us out on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or Podbean. We also have a Patreon to see how many seasons people will force us to watch, so go check that out too at patreon.com/millenniummike. If you don't know how to spell millennium, that's two L's, two N's, and then an M-I-C at the end. Or you could just Google us. I guess that works too. See you there.
Hey, you guys want to hear about cookies?
Yeah. Like the kind that you put in your mouth, or
did I mean, you could put them in your mouth, but someone would make it sexual.
So did you finally play it?
I mean, I played it last time too, but
I don't remember anything after we recorded this podcast.
Yeah, I know you don't.
That's why I re-listen to the podcast, because I don't remember shit we talk about afterward.
Which really sucks, because like when we don't remember, we're a week behind on topics. Because we re-listen.
That's your fault, Jordan. It's all on you. But yeah, Cookie Run Kingdoms, I can finally give it a full, honest review. It sure is a game that exists.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that seems like one of those kinds of games. Fuck you for getting Medi addicted to the shit. You got our fucking executive producer hooked on the shit. I saw you two talking in the fucking Discord about, oh, you got the Columbo cookie. Oh, you got the fucking, you got the pumpkin spice booty bit. You fucking.
Sonic's in that game.
Oh, good lord.
Oh. Have you got Sonic yet?
No, I haven't gotten Sonic. I think that was a limited time thing. I didn't know that was a thing at all. I found out the other day that I think I was in call with ours, and I was like, oh shit, apparently my storage is full from items, and I didn't know that that could happen. And I was like, yeah, they're probably going to tell you to, like, buy something to, like, increase your storage space, because that's what all these shitty things do. And they were just like, you want to give us, like, 8 pieces of wood, like, 5 axes, you can expand your storage. I was like, what the fuck? Like, materials I can make in the game, not money? What the fuck do you mean?
That's extremely generous.
This game is one of the most generous gachas I've ever fucking played. It's insane. It's still fairly money grubby. Like, if you do a pull, they give you a lot of free gems. Just straight up out the gate, they give you, you get 3,000 for playing about maybe 20 minutes of it. And then you could do like a 10 pull. But every time that you draw an epic cookie, they'll go, oh, hey, if you buy this $20 to $25 pack, you can upgrade them to the best they could be immediately. And they give you things that aren't just good for that one character. They give you things that you can use on anybody.
So did you get one for Choco Bonbon?
She's not in this game, you stupid idiot. Otherwise, I would have. No, I got it for the pumpkin one because she is adorable. The one thing that I super hate is that they only give you... they in order to build things, you need sugar gnomes. They only give you 3 of them. And our good friend Shora discovered that they had codes for the game where you could get more sugar gnomes. Like a straight up code you could put in and they would give you 7 of them.
Gnome.
And I went, holy shit, I'm going to go put that in. They were all cosmetic. They weren't real sugar gnomes. They made fake ones for April Fools that you place around your town. So I've placed them in front of my sugar gnomes' houses as a reminder to them who is in charge of this fucking kingdom. And if they don't work their asses off, they're going to end up like that. They're going to be empty little shells.
I think you're getting too heated.
I've just been shaking my head the entire time. I'm so disappointed in you.
Like, it's a fun game.
Like, okay, good.
They give you a lot of shit to do.
Are you having fun?
I guess. I mean, it's a good way to pass the time.
Then that's all that matters.
Other than Master's Axe, you can't even get a fucking... I'm missing like 50 fucking gems in Master's Axe to fucking do a pull. So I have to wait till tomorrow to get more free gems because I'm not spending more money on that.
Just do a daily or the fucking...
I've done all the dailies.
What's that one fucking arena called that they open every couple of weeks?
It's not open now.
Oh, isn't it? I thought I saw a tweet saying... Oh, okay.
Yeah, I have to wait until tomorrow to get the rest of the free gems I need for April.
Do one of the events.
I've done the events.
All of them? There's not a single new area that you can do to get fucking gems for?
There might be, but when they go, all right, this is super hard, it's either, oh yeah, I got a little bit of damage, or my team gets wiped out immediately. There's no in-between.
Okay, do you have any of the, like, day trainer stories that you can do?
No.
Oh, okay.
Actually, check that. I think I did all of them.
Because whenever you get a new trainer,
you get
you get that. Spend a day with them, and then you'll get 10 gems at the end of their little story thing. I skip all of those. I stopped caring a long time ago.
Also, I hate Masters. They only give you, like, 10 gems for those things and 30 for the ones with battles. Fucking Cookie Run Kingdom, you do one mission in the story mode, and they give you 20 gems for clearing the level, 30 gems for getting 2 stars, and 50 gems for getting 3 stars. So you effectively get 100 gems for each level you beat. Plus, if you reach certain levels, they'll go, all right, here's an extra 300 for reaching this level, and they'll hand you you did this daily mission thing, here's another 100 gems. It's like out the ass, this fucking money. Because it's used for more than just pulling in the gacha, you can use it to speed up production on things. It's like everything that they give you is useful in some way, and I'm not used to that in a game.
Yeah, literally the only thing the paid currency is good for in Masters X is pulls and recharging your stamina. That's it.
And I don't even know what the coins are useless in fucking Masters X.
Coins, if you go into the shop and go under the monthly tab, you can you can buy shit. There's shit to buy.
Yeah, but it's not like good shit. It's just like also, you level up things you can go and get yourself. And
also, upgrading gear. If you want to upgrade your gear, you actually need like a decent amount of cash.
Well, I mean, I have over a million fucking coins in that game, so maybe
a million coins.
If I ever
goes,
get gear,
well, you need to grind for it.
I don't even know how to. They handed me one little like equipable item thing,
so
and I haven't gotten another one since.
So recently, they've put out like certain events that give you 3-star gear. They did it for rock types and ghost types. There is gear in the game that only goes up to 2 stars that you can grind for, and that's in the co-op section. If you go to the co-op section under EX Plaza, you can grind for every single types of gears.
It would be under co-op, huh?
Yes.
Why would it be locked to co-op?
But you can do co-op single player. You can form 3 teams of... unless they remove that. I remember seeing them say something about them removing it so they can fix it. But previously, you could make 3 teams. You control 1 team, and the other 2 are controlled by AI.
I mean, I'll look into that, but...
But yeah, if you want gear, stupid, that's how you do it.
This is not my realm of expertise.
I guess I didn't know who that was for a second. Then it sounded like Jordan.
Yeah, it sounded like someone completely different, and I needed to realize like who else is in here.
Let's get the shit out of me.
Because I didn't realize that you had actually put in NPM into the server until I saw him talking in his piss bucket.
What a fucking sentence.
I mean, you can see he's the only one that's typed in there. He's like, hey, there's my piss bucket.
Yeah.
at least he's happy with it.
That's the one thing he has to his name on this.
Yeah, I was gonna
ship.
Say it's a good thing he's happy with it because that's all he's getting.
I didn't really play anything new this week. I just kind of did my regular shit with FF14 and Bloons.
Oh, I haven't played Bloons in so long. I completely forgot about it. Like, I got so enthralled in Inscription that I just completely dropped Bloons altogether. And even when I beat Inscription, I'm like, what's Bloons? Actually, that's not true. I think I turned it on, like, twice and, like, did half a level and then got my shit.
I opened Twitter the other day and I was just like, I wonder what everyone's talking about. And it was just a wall of fucking 14 because that live letter thing happened. And I was like, oh, well, I guess I'm going to close Twitter for the
day. Yeah, I turn off Twitter on those days. Like, the only thing that I got from Twitter is that I think Yoshi P sad. I saw a child, like, wipe the tears off his eyes from the TV. Like, oh, that's cute. And then I turned off Twitter and like, okay, that's good.
I made a joke and I feel really bad about it because of what Casey said after it.
Yeah, he like when he's that high up where he's both producing and directing it, it's obvious that he feels incredibly bad about delaying it this soon.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, let me see if I can find exactly what it was.
Well, it's either apologize for it now and just deal with the grief that comes with it, or put it out in a fucked up state where you need to then, like, hyper-quick fix it, and then apologize for putting out a shitty quality product afterwards. So
the best decision to make.
Yeah, it's the best decision to make at this current point in time.
Considering it's just 2 weeks, I'm willing to bet they found, like, some disastrous bug that'll crash the servers.
Probably.
That they can fix in 3 days.
Or something like game-breaking and exploitive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I had tweeted, after seeing the news, really excited for my Final Fantasy XIV friends being able to play Endwalker on the 23rd. Hope nothing happens to push it back or anything. And responded after with, son of a bitch, and a tweet that said that it was being pushed back. And I was like, that's funny as hell. KZ then responded and went, really striking contrast between you running a bad bit and the director of the game crying on stream for letting people down. I was like, oh, I didn't know he was crying. Oh, fuck. Whoops.
Yeah, because, like,
I didn't know he was actually crying either.
Yeah, he was crying. Like, he acknowledged that people actually requested for paid time off for it.
He was probably shitting his pants. He was probably fucking terrified because people are psychopaths and are probably sending him death threats right now.
For a 2-week delay.
Yeah. These people are insane.
During that stream, they made the mistake of reading chat when the main cat girl of the cast, Ishola, popped up. And the chat was describing her as mommy.
No.
And we had the translator read out, the chat is calling Ishola mommy, Weird.
Yeah, it's so pretty weird.
Like, that felt like a shotgun blast to the chest during that.
Oh, fuck.
What? No comment on the mommy bit?
This is kind of weird.
Yoshi P's not like, so, mommy milkies.
But as much as this 2-week delay sucks, it does give me time to actually play SMT5.
I'm just picturing him, like, on stage, walked away from the mic, like, wiping legit tears away, and they're like, ah, they seem to be calling Stola mommy, and he just perks up, like, oh, Milky?
Oh, God.
Mama Milky?
I want to get off this topic.
You brought it up. You're the one that brought it to this table.
Your mom loves
that
topic.
You finish your plate.
Oh, eat it up.
Anyway, I'm very excited for SMT5.
Looks good.
It looks really good.
That's out in a week, right?
It's out this Friday.
This Friday, nice.
I always feel bad. I keep seeing the tweets that are just like, oh, the average fucking white Nintendo fan who doesn't like RPGs. And I'm like, man, I'm sorry. It's not that I don't like them. I didn't ask to be born this way.
What, white?
Yeah.
Wait, what do you mean?
There is a trend on YouTube where most Nintendo YouTubers are white and cis and have almost all of them have a running bit of, I don't like RPGs.
But Chaka Conroy exists.
Reviewers mainly.
Yeah, it's usually the reviewer types.
The Scott the Wazes, the Arlos.
Yeah, but you can't compare Scott the Waz to Arlo because one of them has talent and the other one's Arlo.
Ooh, God, I don't know who Arlo is.
He's like a little puppet guy. He's a freak. Scary.
Oh, is he a Pikmin or something? Is he the purple one?
No, blue.
He's like blue. Purple? What the fuck do you mean purple?
I don't know. There's so many fucking puppets. One of them's got to be purple.
A lot of little felt fuckers out there. It's scary. I hate it. I like Persona 5. That doesn't make things better.
You should probably play it at some point.
You should.
That's really good. That's a commitment, though. I got Pokemon to do in, like, what, 2 weeks? That comes out on the 19th?
That's really what it is. There's a lot of RPGs that are just really big commitments, and Pokemon I'm familiar with. I've known it all my life. Let me have my baby RPG for babies.
Yeah, this is going to be my 10th time playing fucking through Gen 4, so I'm like, yeah, strap me in. I'm here for it.
And you'll somehow lose.
Oh, as soon as I get to fucking what's her name?
Fantina?
No. Mars with her fucking perugly, that it's all tits up from there. Jordan, you don't understand. I have lost so many fucking Pokemon to that fucking perugly. I have lost.
Yeah, because you're also playing Drayano hacks.
I'm not talking about just Drayano hacks.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about other hacks. One of them was just like a vanilla hack with more Pokemon added into them. That's all it was. It was just base fucking platinum. And I still somehow lost shit tons of Pokemon to her. I've lost so many fucking Pokemon to that fucking Perugly.
Sounds like you should just get good.
It's very difficult to get good. It is very, very difficult.
Although I know there's a lot of like issues with the level curve in the Gen 4, pretty much.
Maybe they fixed it to make it easier for new audiences. I don't fucking know. They're probably going to keep it the same.
Gonna curb stomp your cock and balls into the cement.
Like I was pretty much blind on the remakes. Granted, I don't have to be. I know that game like front and back by now. But I saw them tweet about Team Galactic, and I saw that fucking bitch and her fucking fat cat, and I nearly had a conniption. Got so fucking mad. Just got fucking like nom flashbacks. Just years of literally dealing with this bitch. So mad. Like, I'm mad now. I'm mad now. Thinking about what I've gone through and what I'm gonna go through in, like, 2 weeks' time. Oh, God.
Oh, you guys want some questions?
Yeah, fucking hit me, baby.
Sure.
Want some shit from the crowd? All right. Let's see what we got going on here. Frost Samurai wants to know... I'm not gonna put it in the piss bucket. Hold on. What are your opinions on Kurudin?
What is this?
I like Kurudin.
What is it?
And I put it in general for you to
look at. Oh, okay, but what is it? Like, it's a seal. That's all it is? It's just a seal?
Seal.
She's called the Sea Fairy.
Uh-huh. What is this from?
Precure.
It's one of those Precure series. Oh. I guess the newest one going on.
It's a little too pink. Like, a little less pink. If its fins and ears were, like, not pink, or, like, a different, like, purple. Like, make them purple, make them fucking, like, match its eyes or something.
Why
I don't
are you
know.
Critiquing her? She's trying her best.
I was asked for my opinion, so I'm fucking giving it to you.
I didn't think your opinion would be so mean
it's
to this poor little seal.
It's a C at best.
Holy shit. All right. I think she's doing great.
Could do better.
Next question.
It's fucked up. Ixiot asks, what is a piece of media that you enjoy that you'd never suggest to other people because of its major flaws?
Fucking Yu-Gi-Oh. And here's the thing. The only major flaw Yu-Gi-Oh has isn't really a flaw with Yu-Gi-Oh. It's a flaw with people where people don't like to read. People see the wall of text on Yu-Gi-Oh cards and go, oh, no way, man, too much. Too much, despite having to go through years of fucking doing book reports, reading entire fucking novels, and but they see like a paragraph and a half on a Yu-Gi-Oh card and go, no, man, too much info to take in all at once. I love Yu-Gi-Oh. I can't recommend it to people, like, because they see a pendulum monster and start fucking losing their minds.
Shit, I can't even really think of one.
Dark Souls.
That's
fair.
I personally don't recommend
Dark Souls to people. I like Dark Souls. I don't recommend it to people.
That's fair.
But before the Nier remake came out, I would say Nier, the original Nier, because like, man, that game's got a good ass story. Fuck playing it though.
But then Drakengard.
And Drakengard. It's like, look, if you want to intake everything that's Nier and Drakengard, just go watch the YouTubers. Go watch, like, Klemps or something.
I mean, I guess I could say One Piece, but I mean, I still recommend it to people. So I don't know.
But here's the thing, like, One Piece doesn't really have a flaw other than its length. And that isn't really a flaw. That's once again, a flaw with people.
Yeah.
That don't have the time or wherewithal to dedicate that much time into it, you know?
To enjoy something fucking godly.
People get intimidated by number.
You know what? The Wii Mini. I feel like that's appropriate as an answer.
You don't like that thing.
Yeah, you don't like it.
Listen, don't say that in front of him. He's right there. He can hear you guys.
You did a stream on it. We're talking about how much shit it sucked.
Yeah, but he was working then. He couldn't hear me. Now he's all ears.
He's not even fucking plugged in, you bitch.
He's crying
plug
now.
Him, fucking plug him in. He can't feel nothing if he's not plugged in. Plug him in, then I'll talk shit to his face.
No. I can't give him that much power. Literally, he might explode.
It's true. The sounds that he makes it sound like he will explode.
Deadly Diamonds asks us, if you could play Uno with three famous people, living or dead, who would it be? It'd be myself. Oh, three other people.
Yeah,
I would
others.
Play with the creator of Uno, a gun, and at least two or three bullets.
Okay, but it's got to be a famous gun and a famous bullet.
The bullet that shot through JFK's head.
Okay, what about the gun?
I mean, you know, that's a good question. I don't even know. I would have to be the same gun, I would imagine.
You know, I was going to say the same thing, except for the gun and the bullet. I would say the gun and the bullet from fucking Wanted. Specifically, the gun that shot and killed Morgan Freeman. That'd be dope.
Okay. What's the question again?
If you could play Uno with three famous people, living or dead, who would it be?
I don't know. I don't have an answer to this.
Can you not think of three famous people you would want to hang out with?
Carl,
at all?
His answer is clearly obvious. It's the Jonas Brothers. It's all three of them.
You know, yeah, you're right.
Actually,
yeah.
You know what? Fuck the
this
other two. Just
ended.
Nick Jonas three times. Just grab. just pluck them from three different movies.
All three of them just show up. All three are just Nick
next
Jonas.
Question.
No. Daito asks, what game series do you want to see to have a movie slash animated series adaptation?
None.
Also, would you call the Boondocks an anime?
Yes.
Let me finish the fucking question first.
I thought that was the end of the question. Sorry. Boondocks is absolutely 100% an anime. Can't tell me otherwise. It is an anime.
What game series to see a movie or animated series adaptation?
Once again, none. Nothing whatsoever. Because anything taken to Hollywood. Actually, if it's animated, maybe if like Netflix can take Dark Souls, but not like the main character of Dark Souls. Do like a side story. Like give me Solaire's story and give me like 6 episodes.
I mean, a lot of the good answers are taken already. They've yeah. already happened. They're like, oh, you know, like a proper Mario movie. They're making a Mario movie now. Resident Evil, making a Resident Evil TV series. And they made those shitty movies.
Maybe and a bunch of, maybe you bunch could of do, shitty animated movies.
Maybe you can do Metroid some justice.
Oh, a proper, like, horror Metroid would be really good.
No, they would. Nintendo would never let them do, like, horror.
Have you seen Dread? It's pure fucking horror.
I mean, barely, but okay.
Horror doesn't require gore.
Yeah.
I'm not even talking gore. I'm talking like legit. Oh, well, whatever. Doesn't matter.
Atmosphere.
No, I was just going to let him like take other M and try to adapt that fucking shit into an anime. Yeah,
no.
Yes, that's her origins. No. Come on.
So. It's not her origin.
It's not her origin.
Oh, is
it's
it not
at all?
Did they decanon it?
No, Other M isn't the origin story of Samus. It's a continuation of Super Metroid.
Okay. Well, either way, it's a part of her story.
And technically Fusion.
It's Fusion again.
It's worse Fusion somehow.
I assumed it was her fucking origin because I saw like baby Samus like shitting her diaper over Ridley.
They do have like bits of oh yeah when she was in the Galactic Federation, but fucking stupid. I hate that game.
Game sucks.
Hey, listen, all cool characters need to be lame before they become cool. You aren't born cool. You have to grow into it. And in that game, that was her cool. Lame phase.
Yeah, but she was cool before, and she became lame.
Yeah, they made her fucking lame as shit in that game. Made her obsessed with having a baby.
And listening to a man's orders.
It's okay, that man's a robot now.
He is. Super fucking dead and a robot. Unbacked asks us, what is the most over-the-top awesome thing you've seen in a piece of media? And then they gave the example of Krauser from Fatal Fury breaking his golden armor before fist fighting you. While his personal orchestra plays in the background. They did indeed write fisting fighting. So it threw me for a loop.
Okay. Sorry, I got distracted with fisting. What was the question again?
What is the most over-the-top awesome thing you've ever seen in a piece of media?
Ever seen?
Raiden throwing the Metal Gear Ray into the air and then slicing it in half.
Okay, I don't know if this is ever seen, but like most recent... I would say, without getting into spoilers, I believe it was season... what season are we currently up to in My Hero?
Five?
Five, okay. In season four, when dealing with Bird Gang, and at the end of Bird Gang, when the cool thing happened with Deku... And even before that, when the cool things were happening with fucking, I forget his name. I completely forget his
Mirio.
Name. Mirio. All of that shit was pretty cool too. That whole ending sequence, like, once we got to Mirio and him doing his thing and then everything to do with Deku, that was like some of the hypest shit that I saw.
I can answer this if I could find the title of the exact chapter I'm thinking of.
What's it from?
Chainsaw Man.
Is Chainsaw it what I Man, think it is?
It's one of the best things. Just from this title alone, Chainsaw Man versus the horrifying weapon humans.
Isn't that all Chainsaw Man enemies though?
It's Chainsaw Man's just so fucking good. So much of it is amazing. There is a point where he rides a shark demon with his chains like in its mouth. to use it as like reins to control him into a fucking tornado.
Okay.
It's such a good fucking series. They have a creature called the Gun Devil that just shows up and immediately massacres half of Japan.
Okay.
Just from existing.
Quick yes or no question. Is well, it might not be yes or no. So is the problems in Chainsaw Man demons, or is it just like mutations?
It's demons. It's devils.
Demons. Okay, cool. I'm excited to see that animated. It's coming soon, right?
Oh, I hope so. I'm pretty sure it is.
I saw a trailer for it not too long ago.
Well, I just dropped my bottle opener
or a teaser or whatever.
Yeah, they're animating it, and it looks really good so far. I hope they don't fucking drop the ball.
I would like some Bleach news, please. Any day now.
None of that.
I don't care about the continuation of the manga. Just show me the last animated bit. That's all I fucking want.
I'm going to continue to say no, I don't want any of that until it happens, and then I start marking out on Twitter over it.
Should probably save that for a thing we have planned.
Oh, So Zalkanu asks us, is KZ a himbo?
I don't know what KZ looks like.
You know the character that fucking what's his name, Raymond from Everybody Loves Raymond played in Ice Age.
He's a mammoth.
Yes, I do know who you're talking about. I don't remember his name though.
Yeah, it looks like that. Looks like that woolly mammoth.
Yeah, the woolly mammoth. I was gonna say, like, all right, let's say you take JonTron, right, and let's say you import him to Mexico for a little while.
So fucked.
And you shape his hair like a hat, and you turn his nipples into pepperonis, and there you have KZ. If you take all that together and go, yeah, that's himbo material, then yeah, there you go. He's a himbo.
What the fuck?
These are very Holy old bits. These are very old bits.
Oh my god. Korak 92 asks us, what is your favorite weird foreign food? For me, it was prosciutto and melon pizza at Epcot. And look at you, you disgusting little freak. Prosciutto and melon pizza.
Korak likes fucking white chocolate. He has no fucking taste. Are you okay, buddy? You're okay, buddy?
They call me off guard.
No, because there was one of those things going around asking for people's opinions on Twitter earlier today, right? And it was about chocolate. Like, what's the worst kind of chocolate? And the three options were white, milk, and dark. I'm like, white chocolate is for children or people without tongues. That's my opinion. White chocolate is the worst chocolate, period.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
It's like dark chocolate's not that great either, but I prefer it way over white chocolate. Also, white chocolate gives me like horrible diarrhea. But yeah, fucking Korak goes, but cookies and cream though. And I'm like, shut up, Korak. You and your listen. The only reason I'm getting heated. The only reason people like fucking cookies and cream. It's not for the fucking cream. It's for the fucking cookie, dipshit.
And you might as well just eat cookie dough at that point.
Exactly. Yeah, really. Exactly.
I mean, there's the difference between Oreo cookies and cookie dough.
Mm-hmm.
I would say my favorite weird / foreign food would probably be, hey, you guys ever have Doritos with cream cheese?
No.
No. No, I have not.
Yeah. Yeah, an old friend of mine back when I was in elementary school used to eat that. And I looked at him like he was a psychopath and he went, have you tried it? And I went, no. I tried it and it was pretty good.
I've had chips in like cream cheese like dip base. Like, you know how Philadelphia has like their own dips, like they have an onion dip, but the base of it is cream cheese. I've had that before, but never like straight cream cheese. No. Now, okay. When this question asks for foreign food, does it mean like something that you can go out and purchase, or like something that you concoct at home?
I think it means something outside of your country.
Oh, I would guess I imagine so.
I haven't voluntarily left the country in like 12 years, give or take.
Is that how long Florida was?
I believe, like, I looked up, like how long ago Florida was, and I believe Florida was almost 10 years ago. But yeah, I haven't had anything, like, out of country, or even, like, out of state.
Or anything weird.
Or province. No, like, if this was, like, what, like, homemade concoction have you made that's, like, insanely good? I do have one. Don't judge me, okay? one night, I was really high, and I had fucking Chips Ahoy cookies.
Mm-hmm.
And my go-to thing is to always have a glass of milk when I have cookies, right? Especially Chips Ahoy.
Were they crunchy or chewy?
Crunchy. That's what the milk is for, to soften them up, right? But I was out of milk. The only dairy-based thing that I had at home was this jar of, like, spicy queso dip. And I'm like, fuck it. I'm high. I'll go for it. So I took the chocolate chip cookies and dumped it into the fucking spicy queso dip. And it was really good.
What the fuck?
You know, the fucking, like, queso. You know?
Yeah, like cheese?
Yeah, like a cheese dip.
Like, you just mixed spicy chocolate cheese dip. And cheese?
Yeah, I just dipped chocolate chip cookies in the spicy cheese dip. And it was really okay. I've only ever done it once, and this was, like, 6 years ago. This was, like, 2-3 apartments ago, just one night at, like, 4 o'clock in the morning.
Are the apartments you live in, like, your metric of your times in life?
Kind of. Yeah.
I think the most amazing part of that story is that you could remember something that's happened that long ago, but not what we talked about last week.
No, completely, like, in one ear, out the other.
What about you, Jordan?
I'll be honest, I have no fucking clue what the question is at this point.
Like, just go with whatever. Just go with
favorite
whatever.
Weird food or foreign food that you've eaten?
When I sometimes dip my fries in a shake, I guess.
Oh, that's fucking normie shit these days. They did it on Kim Possible. Normie. There ain't no fucking way. There ain't no way that's classified as weird these days anymore.
It's pretty good.
I've never done that. That's fucking weird.
Oh, you know what? There's something I used to do in middle school. I would take potato chips and I would dunk them into ketchup.
How have I never done that? That's why they made
ketchup chips.
How have I never done that?
Yeah, it's literally
probably
like...
Probably because Canada just straight up has ketchup chips.
Yeah, probably.
That's probably why I've never done that.
It's like eating a french fry with like a really crunchy french fry with ketchup. A fire trooper asks, have you ever seen something bizarre happening in public and somehow got sucked into it?
This is a question.
This is literally cheat meal. Every segment of cheat meal falls under this category. Listen to every single podcast we've ever put out and I've had my food stolen. I've
had your food vomited on.
Exactly. I have a whole catalog. Just go listen to old podcasts or this one. Listen to the beginning of this one and you'll have my answer.
I have a story for this one. When I was little, my cousins were playing outside of their house and an ice cream truck pulled up and they went to go get ice cream from the ice cream man. And the guy, you know, looked at them. He's like, hey guys, I can give you some free ice cream if you want. Just get into the back of my truck. I'll open the door for you.
No,
you can come in and get some ice cream.
No.
One of my cousins went, fuck you, and just picked up a rock and threw it through the window.
Good for him.
And they started screaming for their moms. The guy drove off. So I was in a car with my mom, my sister, and another one of our cousins. And she got the phone call from those cousins' mom that this had happened. And she went, we're going to find this motherfucker. I'm going to track him down. He doesn't do this to our fucking family. I was like, what do you mean? I'm like 6 years old or something. Not older than that, like 8 or something. I'm like... Like, do you know, like, he's probably long gone by now. There's no way that we're ever gonna fucking catch the set. I couldn't even finish the sentence. She went, there's the motherfucker. We were driving by
just
a fucking convenience store.
Just the first poor ice cream driver that they see.
Yeah. She saw specifically the exact, I think it was a Mr. Softy truck with the exact window broken.
Oh, Mr. Sitting in
Mr. a fucking
Softy
convenience
trying to give
store
you a Mr.
by the
Hardy.
Train tracks. He didn't get that far at all. He's just like at this convenience store by the train tracks. She pulls up. You know how the they used to have those things to lock the steering wheels in cars, like those bars?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
She grabbed that and took the metal bar out. And she looked at us with stay in the car. Like, call the police, tell them to show up. The guy got into his truck. She went over, started whacking on the truck with this metal bar. You motherfucker! What do you think you're doing to my nephews? The police showed up. They had to drag her away. They're like, ma'am, we'll have to arrest you if you keep trying to assault him. And she's just like, just hit him a couple times. Just hit him a little bit. Rough him up for me.
Damn, your mom's badass. Well, fuck with her.
Is that dude actually a pedophile, or was he just an ice cream truck?
Okay. No, he was the guy. It was the exact ice cream man that tried to get them in the truck.
But did he, like, get charged for anything? Or?
Yes, he did.
Oh, okay, good. Well, that's good at least.
And my mom almost got charged with murder and assault and battery.
Not murder, attempted murder, maybe.
Attempted murder.
Yeah.
Attempting is different in this podcast.
What about you, Jordan? You ever been sucked into something weird?
The closest I can think of is when my mom got, like, T-boned, like, 14 years ago with me and my sister in the car.
Oh, damn.
And,
is everyone okay?
Like, yeah, everybody was okay. That's good. It's just that the people that were behind us in the road, like, stopped, and they were this old couple, and they went and got me and my little sister, like, big-ass cookies from the gas station to help us, because we were, like, bawling our eyes out.
They're trying to pay you off with cookies. That would have worked. No, that would have worked on me.
They weren't the people that hit us.
Okay, that's good.
My mom got T-boned at a cross-section.
The other guy get fucked?
I have no idea. It's been so long that I don't remember.
You could have watched someone. You could have, like, been in the area that someone's dead body was.
Nobody died. I know that for sure. I just don't remember if the...
That they've told you.
I just don't remember if, like, the dude fucked off or was really apologetic.
Mommy, why is that guy laying limp in the car? Don't look. No. Don't look over there.
No.
Look at the cookies. Look at the cookies the nice old people gave you as the old people are trying to pull the body away.
Are there any more questions?
Yes. Sholm's Schlacking. Asks us, boat related, if you were stranded on a boat with one person and one item while waiting to be rescued, who would you choose and what would be your item of choice to pass the time with?
Oh, just to pass the time with? My brother and peyote. That's it. Those are the two things. Right. That's all I need.
Are you done peyote?
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
That's like the intense shit,
yeah,
right?
Pretty much. That's as, like, outside of, like, DMT, that's as good as it gets.
I would say an electric razor in Jordan.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. I would say a knife in Carl.
What the fuck? I'm just saying I'm going to shave your head bald and slap it purple like the Grimace.
Yeah, you're not going to do that.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Are you certain?
Yep.
Are you 100%? Are you hundo P certain that I'm not going to do that to you?
I'm not 100% certain that you're not going to do that. I'm just 100% certain that you won't do it.
You can think that all you want. Listen, Jordan, I got to make you look like this.
What is that? Even? Oh, okay. I get it now. But yeah, what's wrong with this pinky? That looks wrong. He looks like he's supposed to be a Simpson with only four fingers, and somebody went, oh fuck, he's meant to have five, and then quickly, like, added that on. It looks so wrong.
Oh my god.
Either that or he has a bone spur and that's keeping his fucking pinky weird.
Next question.
Jordan, what's your fact for us?
Oh, is it fact time?
I mean, hey, we're a good couple over. We got no other questions.
This one just sounded funny because of the name. One of the fastest speedboats in the world is called the Problem Child.
Oh, so you.
I'm not a problem child.
So it's the Jordan.
I'm not a problem child.
You sure about that?
You're a pretty big problem. Look at you. Little nasty man.
I'm not nasty.
Little nasty freak.
I shower.
Little smelly guy.
I shower. You don't know what
Thank
I
you all for
like.
Listening to this. You're asking for it.
What a bad
ending.
Thank you
all for listening to this episode of DipShips. No, see you on the nautical mile.
How dare you steal the captain's bit? See you later, everybody.
Bye. What a terrible ending. This is the worst ending we've had so far. It only took 9 episodes to get the shittiest ending we've ever done.
Is that episode 9?
Is it? I don't know. I'm assuming.
It's episode 8.
I can't count. I don't know how to count.
We'll see you all on the nautical mile.
Toodles.
That's my bit. Stop. Stop. What are you doing? That's literally my thing. Excuse you? Literally stealing my bit.
Hello and welcome to DipShips.
No.
Episode.
No.